kill somebody. And y'all gonna act like you got a pass card. Some of y'all think because you black, you holy. Some of y'all think because you Baptist, you holy. But let me come by and tell you something. Your holiness ain't tied to your history. You better ask somebody. You need to know him for yourself. The choices you make determine your consequences. Boy, have a witness here. You out here talking about we want a holy church. Well, if you want a holy church, you got to act like it. You can't stop praying and think God going to bless you. You can't stop reading God's word and think God going to bless you. You can't turn your back on God when you want to and then turn to God asking to bless you. You think you all of that. You bigger than God. God said, okay, if you want to live by yourself,
have it.
Folks. See, God, what he does, a lot of times he just step back.
Yes, sir.
Like I told you, like that boy was smoking that cigar, him and his buddies. And his daddy caught him. And when his daddy caught him smoking the cigar, oh, I'm sorry, daddy, you want to put the cigar on? I said, oh, no, sir, don't put it out. Take another puff. Took another puff. Oh, he thought he's wearing a non smoking cigar. Took another puff.
Yeah.
Took another one. The head started kind of getting a little light. Yeah. I had enough. Oh, no, sir. No. I've had enough. You take another puff. You want to smoke a cigar? Got a whole lot of cigar left on that. Say, Daddy made him smoke the whole cigar. Sick for a week. He was telling this story, this is real story. He was telling this story when he was grown. And he said, to this day, when I see a cigar, I start getting nauseous. Y'all don't hear me. And see, when I found God doesn't always try to punish you, sometimes God just steps away from you. When you think you're strong enough to handle yourself, I said, okay, handle it. Yeah. You think you're all that bad, you know so much, God said, okay, handle it. Yeah. I told him, I don't want to be anywhere where God is not. I don't care where I go, wherever I go, whatever, I want to make sure where I go, God is there. Yeah. I don't care who else disagrees with me, I want to make sure. As honest as the heart of that is that I'd rather have God for me and the whole world against me than to have the whole world for me and God be against me. I wish I had a witness here. Oh yeah, there's some consequences to how you call it. And so if you want a church, the kind of church God can be pleased with, you got to make the right choices. You got to make sure you base the church on the right kinds of things. If you want a kind of church that God wants to grow, this got to be a Bible-based church. Come on here, somebody. That's all I see up in here. You got to base it on the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh. If you want a Bible-based church with God in control, you got to have a praying church. And saying praying church don't make it so. I told my secretary before she left and she answered the phone, Bethany, a praying church. Well, we believe in Pastor, the word of God. I said, you need to stop lying on that phone to folk. Because being a praying church means more than just saying you're a praying church. You can't say you're a praying church and folk at church don't pray. Oh, it's tight, but it's sure enough right. Church and you don't want to move over to let somebody sit down. I wish I had been. I just told you the Spirit of God. What part of God told you to frown at a visitor when they came in? What part of God told you not to speak to folk with a smile when they came to church? What part of God told you to remember something somebody did 20 years ago? shake the pastor's hand that way. What part of God told you that you can treat folk the way you want to treat them, but God don't bless you the way he wants to bless you? How can you say you love me whom you never seen, and you hate your sister and your brother that you look at every day? Man, I wish I had a witness. He didn't say love them because they lovable. He didn't say love them because they do right. Because if love required right, he wouldn't love any of us. But while we were yet sinners, come on here somebody, he was loving on us while we were messed up. He didn't wait till we took a bath. We were still stinking. We were still stained. We were still messed up. And in spite of us, he loved us anyway. When the prodigal son came home, he didn't say bathe him first, but he hugged him while he was all, wish I had, musky and messed up. He didn't try to get the pig mess off of him. He hugged him while he had all that mud and crud on him. He hugged him the way he was. And we got to learn how to love folks, not after they get straight. We got to love them before they get straight. When you have the integrity of God, it doesn't mean that you write all the time. But when you got God's integrity, he sets a standard that you're trying to get better. You're trying to grow. That's why Paul said, some things I got to forget. I just told you. You see, if you keep trying to hold on to when folk mess with you, you can't get to where God's trying to get you. Wish I had a witness here. You still trying to hold on to somebody cussing you out? I wish I had a witness here. You can't get to the point where God can help you to stop cussing all of you. Do I have a witness here? You trying to hold on when somebody dug a ditch for you and you keep your shovel with you. God said instead of a shovel, you need some words. Shovel to dig holes. Get your bulldozer and fill the holes in. Do I have a witness here? Y'all be good. Let me let y'all go home. Remember, I see ideal integrity. Paul said we ought to mind the same thing. So the Spirit of God in us calls us to want the same thing. We all want to, should want to glorify God. We all should want to lift God up, high for men to see. I heard Jesus when he says, if I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men, that's women too, unto me. Do I have a witness here? But my brothers and sisters, Paul said that he gave us different gifts. Apostles, pastors, teachers. You know the list. All for the perfecting of the saints. For the edifying of the body. For the building up of the body of Christ. Oh, I wish I had a witness. You know? In other words, we're not here to tear folk down. We're here to build somebody up. We're not here to say what's wrong with the church. We're here trying to make the church right. We're not here trying to pass our laws, but we're here trying to promote the word of the Lord. Do I have a witness here? That's all I'm asking you. Whose will is the most important to you? Your will more important than God's will? Is your way more important than God's way? You know what stops a whole lot of folk from being better? They hold it on to what they want. They can only talk about the way I see it. I hate to bust your bubble, but it really don't give a fat rat about the way you see. What you see and what you say ain't that important. Up against what God said. The only thing that validates what I say is when I say what God told me to say. Then what I say ain't what I say. It's what God said. Y'all got on a story about the kids playing. And one of the younger sisters went and said, y'all come on in this house. And they looked at her and said, we ain't got to do what you said. They kept on playing. She waited a second and said, mama said,
yeah.
Y'all come on in this house.
Yeah.
I wish I had a witness here. They've been on and got in the house. The first time she said it, she just said, I said it. But when she said, mama said it,
yeah.
Come on here, somebody.
Yeah.
That carried a whole lot more weight with it.
Yeah.
Do I have a witness here?
Yeah.
Don't worry about what Haynes said, but you ought to be concerned about what the Lord said.
Yeah.
And you know what I found out about the Lord when you headed in the wrong direction? He knows how to get things right. Two more minutes. Well, you remember Paul's name Saul going down the Damascus Road?
Yeah.
He was doing God's will to persecute the church.
Yeah.
And Jesus said, I got to get you right.
Yeah.
That's what Paul says. When you know what's right,
right.
You ought to do what's right.
Yeah. Yeah.
When you know what's right, you ought to live according to right.
Yeah.
No, we don't have a license to do whatever we feel like doing.
Amen.
God sets the rules. God set the standards. I don't care how many people vote on wrong. Wrong is still wrong. You can legalize homosexuality all you want. It still doesn't make it right. I wish I had a witness here. You can try to justify everybody is committing adultery. Adultery is still a sin. You don't have a witness here. You can talk about fornication is something everybody does who's not married. But that still doesn't make it right. If God says it's a sin, come on, hear somebody. It's a sin. And it'd be all right if you could stop right there, but he put a little footnote in. Said the payday for sin, the wages of sin, come on, hear somebody, is that you gotta die. And when he talk about dying, he goes, I don't mind dying. Well, he ain't talking about leaving this world. He's talking about spiritual death, physical death, eternal death. Spiritual death means you're separated from God. Physical death means you're separated from your body. But eternal death means you are eternally separated from God. Do I have a witness here? They want to debate whether hell got fire or not. I really don't know whether there's fire in hell, but this much I know. Whatever's going on down there, it ain't nothing nice. If there's no fire in hell, you're going to feel just about as worse as if you got burned up. It ain't nothing nice. It's torment, it's pain, it's agony. Hell is not a place that you want to go. We got a testimony from hell from a rich man. Witness here. Let me close talking about the Savior and the illumination.
Yes, sir.
Following Jesus means being led by the Spirit.
Yes, sir.
And when you're led by the Spirit, He grows you into integrity.
Right.
That's what happened. Saul grew into Paul.
Yes.
And Paul says, I count not myself, come on here somebody, to have apprehended. But I keep on pressing. In other words, I haven't reached it, but I'm working on it. I'm not where I ought to be, but I'm working on it. What's wrong with Paul? You see, folk who think they're perfect are folk who don't talk to God. You heard me say it before. When I talk to God, standing with God shows me where I'm messed up. perfection, it shows up my imperfection.
All right.
When I see God cleanliness, it shows my uncleanliness.
Yeah.
Somebody said, Reverend, you got on a white suit. This ain't no white suit.
Yeah.
This is an off-white suit. Got stripes all up in it.
Yeah.
Y'all need to understand something. There's a difference between cream and white.
Yeah. Yeah.
Y'all don't hear me.
Yeah.
And you see, we got too many spiritual cream folk. Think they're all left.
Yeah.
Now, then what you need to do, you need to be washed, not in intensified time, not in some Clorox, but you got to be washed in the blood. Shows me how to get it right.
Yeah.
When I follow Jesus, he shows me how to get better.
Yeah.
He uses that word Paul used for perfect. It's the Greek term, the Greek word, same one he used in verse 12 and verse 15. It's the Greek word for elosis. It means a mature kind of thing.
All right.
In other words, you got a child and then you got a grown person.
Yeah.
Do I have a witness here?
Yeah.
You got the young and then you got the old. In other words, Paul says, I'm not perfect, but I'm not where I used to be. I'm not a novice. I'm not just starting this thing. I've been running for a long time. But I still have some areas of improvement. I still have some things I'm working on. Well, I'm closing now, but I just want to close on a good note. I want to tell you that integrity is something you get from walking with the Lord.
Yeah.
Integrity comes from God.
Yeah.
And the writer of the Hebrews says, a man, a woman, boy, or girl who walks in integrity reaps the benefit thereof. But when you walk in perverseness, you mess it up your life.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, the Bible is still true. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. You can't go around digging pits for folk thinking that no pits will be dug for you. You can't go around slandering folk name without expecting your name to get slandered too. You can't go around trying to talk about other people's garbage and don't think some of that stink ain't gonna rub off on you. A man that she wasn't married to. And they took it upon themselves to text her husband to tell him what she was doing.
Yeah.
I wish I had a witness here.
Yeah.
My first question is, why am I hearing about this on the news?
Yeah.
I wish I had a witness here.
Yeah.
Number one, it ain't my business who that man was texting.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whether he married or not. Number two, how did the news media find out? I know the wife didn't tell me. The husband didn't tell me. So it must be the two. I wish I had a
witness.
What verse in the Bible you use to justify meddling in somebody else's business? If that woman go home and her husband shoots her to death, how much credit you gonna take for that murder? Do I have a witness here? Or she might be messing around on the phone with somebody she knows that she got an agreement with. In other words, you meddling in business that you ain't got nothing to do with. I done told y'all too many times, you know what? It takes 6 months to keep yourself straight, trying to walk right and do right. And it takes 6 more months to keep your nose out of other folk business. Do I have a witness here? Ain't got no change. If I had a quarter on me, I'd give you a quarter so you can go buy you 25 cents worth of business. And you start tending to your business and leave other folks' business. Come on here, somebody. You want somebody else's business to tend to? Tend to the Lord's business. I said he matures us. And when I walk with Jesus, he changes. Jesus, he gives me a different perspective.
Yeah.
When I walk with Jesus, he gives me a new attitude.
Yeah.
When I walk with Jesus, he makes me work.
Yeah.
But it's not hurting kind of work. It's a labor of love.
Yeah.
Come on here, somebody. Not only does he make me labor, he makes me love.
Yeah.
And love, I told you, conquers all. There's no problem loving folk, helping folk who you love.
Yeah.
I told your daddy, told me you can't pastor folk you don't love.
Yeah.
But I learned that you love folk, you don't love folk because they do you right. You love folk in spite of the way they treat you. You love folk in spite of the way they talk about you. You love folk in spite of the way they wish evil on your life. And if you pray for them, you pray that God blesses them to grow in the word. Because your worst persecutor can become your best support. Go back to Saul. Saul was killing Christians. But before it was over, he says, I've labored more abundantly than they all. In other words, number two, what are you going to do about it? Yes, the Bible says if you have aught against your brother, you go to your brother, but you go in the spirit of meekness. You don't gossip God over your brother and tell everybody before you talk to him, because you might be talking about something you don't know what you're talking about. And then he said, if you don't get it, then you take two. The truth may be established. In other words, all I'm trying to do is gain my brother. But he said, if he doesn't hear you, then you bring him before the church. He ain't talking about Sunday morning, because Sunday morning, this ain't just church. Sunday morning, you got the hallelujah crowd. You got the club crowd. You got the gossiping crowd. You got folk who don't even belong to the church. They just belong to this church. Yeah, no, you gotta pray where you got some praying, spirit-filled saints who trying to grow people into being the people of God. And he said, if they don't hear them, then you count them as a heathen, but you don't throw them out. You keep praying for them and trying to help them out. It ain't only